You're listening to The Hour of the Time, and I'm Pooh.
And I'm William Cooper.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And folks, I wanted to say something to you. Good night, folks, and God bless you all.
Aha! You've been listening to The Hour of the Time. Good night.
Good night. God bless you all.
See you later.
Okay.
I'll be in to tuck you in after a while.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've got a lot of stuff here to go over with you. And I think you're going to be absolutely amazed, shocked, disturbed, whatever you want to call it. You're not going to like some of what you're going to hear. But that's, you know, isn't that the way of the world? It certainly is the way of the world now, this moment, today. Remember, listen to everyone, read everything, believe absolutely nothing, unless you can prove it in your own research.
If you want a lover, I'll do anything you ask me to. If you want another kind of love, I'll wear my leather mask for you. If you want a partner, take my hand. Or if you want to strike me down in anger, here I stand. I'm your man. If you want a boxer, I will step into the ring for you.
Well, folks, I want to try to get as much of all of this on the air as I possibly can tonight. Somebody's ringing the phones to death, so I'm going to see what in the world is so important that they, well, they just stop now. So, good. I have here in my hand it is a request for applications from experienced police officers to serve as international police monitors with the United Nations in Bosnia. Didn't Clinton tell us that was a NATO thing? Well, it's not, folks. NATO was formed under the auspices of the United Nations. It is a United Nations operation going on in Bosnia. Our troops are under, they say, NATO command, but it is really United Nations command. And they are setting up a United Nations, what would you call it? It's going to be a United Nations protectorate is what it's going to be, really, in Bosnia. And it's going to be policed by United Nations police. It's going to be run by, in fact, it's just unbelievable what they're doing to those people over there. The government that they're going to establish has to have on its governing board members from other countries. Can you believe this? This is just one giant step toward the New World Order. Request for applications from experienced police officers to serve as international police monitors with the United Nations in Bosnia. The American contingent is part of a planned 1,750-person group drawn from over 30 countries deployed in Bosnia. The international police monitors will be stationed throughout the country, including Sarajevo and many smaller cities and towns. The contingent commander will report directly to an American, Robert Wasserman. Robert Wasserman is the deputy commissioner of the United Nations International Police Task Force. And remember, I told you that he used to be the White House head of the White House drug control policy. And I told you that quite a while ago, that he was selected to be the head of the International United Nations Police Force in Bosnia. He's worked for police departments in Dayton, Ohio, Houston, Texas, Boston, Mass., and most recently served as chief of staff at the White House Office of National Drug Control Policy. Ultimately, the International Police Monitor's role is to promote the successful implementation of the peace plan through the improvement of police services in Bosnia. In the process, participating police officers from the United States have much to gain by these people, folks. It's unbelievable. U.S. citizen, minimum 8 years full-time civilian police experience to include experience in training and patrol. Military experience may provide partial substitute for some civilian police experience. Ability to communicate in English. Current U.S. driver's license and ability to drive a 4x4 vehicle. Unblemished background record. Excellent health without temporary or permanent disabilities. Salary is $2,666.67 a month, tax exempt, they say, but that's against the law, because according to law, if you're overseas, no matter who you're working for, only the first $15,000 is tax exempt. Well, they're giving these people complete tax exempt status. At $2,666.67 a month, they get $3,200 one-time compensation completion bonus at the end of 1 year. Plus, they get $120 a day for the first 30 days and $90 a day thereafter. Experience has shown that the tax-free allowance is more than ample to live in this area. Total compensation is $88,500 a year for a policeman. Ay, Chihuahua. And additional benefits, they get medical care, disability insurance, uniforms, travel, and on-site transportation, and 2 weeks leave, which brings it well over probably $120,000 total compensation package. And I'm not going to tell you who to fax or call because, personally, I don't have any use for anybody who would want to do this. So I'm not going to help you if you do. Okay. Now, this is from the New York Times, Thursday, December 15th, 1960. Many people have challenged my assertion in my book, Behold a Pale Horse, that the Brookings Institution did a study and gave a report that said that Earth's civilization and religions might topple if faced by a race of superior beings. So we dug up the proof, ladies and gentlemen. You see, I saw that report when I served with the Office of Naval Intelligence. It's not available to the public, or was it the last time we checked. And so I could never really prove that that report existed, and many people have challenged me on that. So we went on a search, and we found it, folks. The New York Times, Thursday, December 15th, 1960. The New York Times, Thursday, December 15th, 1960. And I don't know what page it's on. But anyway, here's the article. It says, mankind is warned to prepare for discovery of life in space. Brookings Institution report says Earth's civilization might topple if faced by a race of superior beings. Washington, December 14th, United Press International, discovery of life on other worlds could cause the Earth's civilization to collapse, a federal report said today. This warning was contained in a research report given to the National Aeronautics and Space Administration with the recommendation that the world prepare itself mentally for the eventuality. The report prepared by the Brookings Institution said, while the discovery of intelligent life in other parts of the universe is not likely in the immediate future, it could nevertheless happen at any time. Discovery of intelligent beings on other planets could lead to an all-out effort by Earth to contact them, or it could lead to sweeping changes or even the downfall of civilization, the report said. Even on Earth, it added, societies sure of their own place have disintegrated when confronted by a superior society, and others have survived even through change. Clearly, the better we can come to understand the factors involved in responding to such crises, the better prepared we may be. The agency's 190-page report, prepared at a cost of $96,000, was for the Space Agency's Committee on Long-Range Studies. The authors, headed by Donald N. Michael, also recommended further study of other space activities, including the diplomatic and propaganda effects and the implications of communications and weather satellites. On the question of life in outer space, the report said that if intelligent or semi-intelligent beings were discovered in the next 20 years, they would probably be found by radio communications with other solar systems. Evidence of such existence might also be found in artifacts left on the moon or other planets, it said. An attempt already has been made to contact outer space. Government scientists at Greenbank, West Virginia, used radio antennas in an effort to pick up signals that might have been beamed by intelligent beings. They concentrated on a star about 15 light years away. Signals sent out from Greenbank were of a kind that would show to anyone listening on other planets that they were man-made, not the result of natural phenomena. You know, a question comes to mind. If those beings on other planets were not man, how would they know what man-made was? Isn't it funny how we automatically take things for granted? Also, there are rumors flying around, and some people are perpetrating those rumors, that the comet Hayakutake is going to hit the Earth. And I'm here to tell you it's not. So take all the baloney you've been passing around, throw it in the trash right now. And go look in the mirror and say, shame on you. You've been stupid again. And you have. I mean, it's flying all over the place. Phony documents. Fraudulent crap. Claiming that this comet is going to crash into the Earth. It's not going to crash into the Earth. So forget it. Socorro, New Mexico, March 24th. Astronomers and amateur stargazers are keeping watch worldwide this weekend for comet Hayakutake, which is due to pass unusually close to Earth and may offer clues about the origins of the solar system. It passed close to the Earth, folks. It did not run into the Earth. In fact, it was about 9.3 million miles away, ladies and gentlemen. Shame on you. Shame on all of you. You just pick this stuff up and fly with it. You never bother checking. You never bother calling anybody. I actually have people calling me to find out what's going on in their hometown. Can you imagine that? Okay. On the Hot Topic section of Michael Reagan's internet webpage, there are three papers. One of the BOD of the Diebold Group, the second of the drawing of the plans they have for this country, and the third, the information that their findings were given to the Council on Foreign Relations. Ross Perot is one of the BOD directors. The drawing shows how they've made their plans for a one-world government, how the Supreme Court will rule in 1997, and how the United Nations will regulate the utilities. Representative Trafficante from Ohio announced yesterday that the Diebold Group papers will be entered, actually it was day before yesterday, will be entered into the congressional record, and he's calling upon a congressional investigation into the Council on Foreign Relations Group. Trafficante wants to know how the Diebold Group have the power to set Supreme Court decisions, among many other questions that should be asked. And I have the papers right here in my hands, folks, and this was all part of the Hillary healthcare thing, too. They were all mixed up in this. Remember, I told you Ross Perot is not on our side. And he's not, folks. This is from the Diebold Institute Commission. The project is being advised by a commission of influential individuals from the public and private sectors in Europe and the United States. The commission is also concerned with focusing attention on the findings and recommendations of the project. The members of the commission are United States, Dr. Craig I. Fields, President and CEO, MCC Corporation. Robert W. Galvin, Chairman, Executive Committee, Motorola Incorporated. Maurice R. Greenberg, Chairman, President and CEO, American International Group Incorporated. John D. McCumber, Chairman, President and CEO, Export-Import Bank of the United States. H. Ross Perot, Chairman, The Perot Group. Dr. F. Roy Vigelos, Chairman and CEO, Mark and Company Incorporated. From Europe, Dr. Karl-Heinz Kaska, chairman of the supervisory board of Siemens AG, Jacques Maigerouge, former chairman IBM World Trade and former director general of Industry for France, Dr. Heinz Reisenhuber, Minister for Research and Technology, Federal Republic of Germany, the Right Honorable Lord Sharp of Grimsdyke, Stanhope Properties, PIC, former chairman, Cable and Wireless PIC, Dr. Warner Ungerer, Rector College of Europe, Institute of Postgraduate European Studies, former German ambassador to the European Commonwealth. And it's all here, folks, by date, everything. It goes all the way up to 2011, from 1992, all the way up to 2011. 2010 is the date for the completion of the world government. And this is an interesting little thing here. In the next stages of the project, we expect to carry out the work outlined in the above paragraphs. Our results will be reviewed with the key participants and public policy groups. In parallel, we shall be disseminating our results both in the United States and abroad. The process has already begun with presentations to the Council on Foreign Relations, CFR, New York, the New York Academy of Sciences, and the Center for European Policy Studies, Brussels. Our dissemination program aims to create a dialogue with participants in order to strengthen and expand our analysis, and if possible, to stimulate others to implement our recommendations, particularly those related to quantitative analysis, where considerably more work is required. How about that, guys? Ay, Chihuahua. So you think world government is a myth, huh? And you think the officer corps of the military service couldn't possibly be involved in this, right? You don't think old Lieutenant Colonel Greitz knows anything about it or is involved in any way, even though he attended the War College. Is that correct? Well, hang your heads in shame, because you've been stupid again. I'm holding in my hands a book, ladies and gentlemen, published by the Strategic Studies Institute, United States Army War College. Let me say that again for you, just in case you missed it or have wax in your ears. A book published by the Strategic Studies Institute, United States Army War College. You'll also remember that on several episodes of the Hour of the Time, I told you that I thought that the effort to cement world government by the year 2000 had been significantly set back by the activities of me and others like me, the formation of the militias, their inability to disarm the American people, and many other things. And I even gave a date. I said that the world government would take form sometime between the year 2010 and 2013. And you can go back in the old tapes and you can hear me say that. I think I said it three or four times over the last 4 years. Well, guess what this says, ladies? Guess what the title of this book is? It's printed by the Strategic Studies Institute, United States War College, United States Army War College, which Bobo Gritz attended, and this is a revision of an earlier plan that had stated that world government would take place before or by the year 2000. This is a revision, and this is the exact title. I'm going to read it to you right now. Quote, A World, 2010, A New Order of Nations. How about that? Remember, world government is taught in the war college. It's taught in all of the military academies as the answer to war. They could not be doing what they're doing in Washington, D.C. They could not be placing our troops under United Nations command. They could not be subverting the Constitution, which all officers and enlisted men are sworn to protect and defend against all enemies, foreign and domestic, if the highest ranking officers in all four of our military services were not complicit in this plan to bring about one world government. So, I think you people had better sit down, and you had better understand that we're not lying to you. We're not joking you. We're not yanking your chain. We're not taking you down the path through the garden path, so to speak. We're telling you the truth. And if you don't wake up to it very quickly, it may be too late for you to wake up. I hope that's hitting you right square between the eyes. What's happening, ladies and gentlemen, is happening as planned. There's a plan for this. It's being brought about not by accident, but by careful planning, by carefully manipulating and propagandizing the populations of the world. And every night on this broadcast, I am speaking to the entire world. You see, it is important that all nations understand that if Americans lose their battle to maintain their freedom, freedom is lost everywhere in the world. You will go backwards into slavery. This is no joke. This is serious stuff. If we here lose, the world loses. This is the last bastion, the last defense, the last line of freedom. This is the place where it will be decided for everyone listening in every country, on every continent, on every island, in the entire world. If they succeed in disarming the American people, subjugating this nation to a world socialist government, which is the form that it's going to take, they make no secret of it, then the entire world loses. The entire world will give up freedom. Because none of you ever had the freedom to begin with that we have today in this nation, even though we've lost a significant portion within the last few years. If we're not careful, we're going to lose it all. If we lose it all, you're going to lose what little you ever had or have been fighting for so many years and have not yet attained. You had better listen to me. The reason the battle rages mainly in the United States of America is because this is the only country that needs be won. The rest of you will fall easily under control. You have no weapons. You have no concept of freedom because you've never had it. You yearn for something you don't even know what it is. While here in America, those who have traditionally enjoyed the freest, most opportune, most well-educated, highest standard of living life in the world have become so complacent, so ignorant, so apathetic, and so stupid that they, while you're yearning for what they have, they are in the process of giving it up. In exchange for some imagined security to protect them from criminals that have been contrived and for the most part do not even exist. A World 2010, A New Order of Nations, published by the Strategic Studies Institute, United States Army War College, as a revision of an earlier report which stated that this would happen by or before the year 2000. Describes a world where the influence of one superpower of the 20th century is diminished, and where the government and the nation of the other has collapsed and reorganized into several new national entities. It also portrays a world where 20th century third world nations achieve a new status in the world's family of nations. where new international status and alignments lead to a new world order. The new order places the nations of the world in 2010 in five groups according to their relationship to modernization and industrialization under a centralized world government. We have much more. Over the last 4 years of broadcasting on the hour of the time, ladies and gentlemen, I have documented to you in the law, in treaties, given you sites, numbers, titles, exact places to look for them. We've even made the treason documents available for you to purchase and use in your own research. We have proven beyond any shadow of a doubt that there is a world government coming. That it is being brought about mainly by those in power within the United States government. Now, don't get this wrong, folks. It is not the United States government that is doing this, because the United States government is the Constitution for the United States of America and the Bill of Rights. It is those communists, Marxists, socialists, members of what is known as the Illuminati, the highest initiates or adepts of the so-called fraternal organizations of the world, who call themselves the Brotherhood, the Order, the Illumined Ones, the Magi. You see, they have infiltrated all levels of our government. The Venona Project, which is a deciphering of intercepted cables that were sent back and forth from the United States to the Soviet Union by Soviet agents in this country that have just recently, within the last 2 weeks, been released, have proved absolutely, unequivocally, and without reservation, beyond any shadow of a doubt, that Joseph McCarthy was absolutely 100% right, that our government was thoroughly and completely infiltrated by communist agents who have destroyed us from within. These same communist agents, through their mechanisms of ownership and control of the media, succeeded in destroying Joseph McCarthy. Because of that, and because of the fear that anyone, from that moment on, if they tried to ferret out the traitors, the communists, and the socialists in our government, would be blackballed, ostracized, and publicly labeled a McCarthyite, they were able to bring in more agents, more infiltrators, and to promote communists and Marxist socialists and those known as the Illuminati into the highest levels of the government of the United States of America and of the several states. We are now in the hands of those people, ladies and gentlemen. And they are in the process of destroying this once great nation and relegating us to a life without property, with a redistribution of wealth to the third world nations from the United States, in a system of cashless debt chained to a computer, under a world totalitarian socialist government, which is now known as the United Nations. ¶¶ Brought to you by Swiss America Trading. That's our Fort Knox in Phoenix that really does have some gold. And you need to get your hands on some kind of real money, and you need to do it very quickly. You see, this country is fixing to come apart at the seams by design. Not by accident. How many of you really think that it's a coincidence that the FBI decided to surround these Freemen up in Montana just before April the 19th? Things are going to get much worse before they even begin to get better. There is legislation in Congress right now which actually out-Hitlers Hitler, ladies and gentlemen. Every chance Charles Schumer and Arlen Specter get, they stand up and holler about the Nazis in this country who are known as patriots and militias. I'm going to tell you right now, those two guys can holler all they want to. They are the Nazis, along with all of the other members of Congress. And I'm talking about House of Representatives and Senate. If you could see what I have laid in front of me, ladies and gentlemen, you would probably throw up for hours. You would be so physically ill. You would probably take to your bed. It would affect you that strongly. You would be debilitated, mentally and emotionally drained, demoralized. Everything that you've ever been taught could not happen is happening in this country right now. When I said America is fixing to come apart at the seams, I was not joking. I was not making a metaphor. I'm telling you exactly like it is. By design. They're actually trying very hard to instigate some kind of a confrontation. And if they try hard enough, some stupid group of people who cannot think and don't know what that big blob of flesh between their ears is really for is going to fall for it. And that will begin a long process of war, disintegration, anarchy, looting, raping, starvation, confiscation of property, the breakup of families, confiscation of children, you name it, it's coming. I suggest very seriously that you get your hands on a movie called America, A-M-E-R-I-K-A, and watch it. You see, it's no coincidence that an incident happened in that movie, right along the lines of Oklahoma City. In the movie, it causes a breakup of the nation into three nations, actually. And the one containing Oklahoma City is called the Heartland. This disintegration process is already well underway, ladies and gentlemen. Most of you cannot recognize it. Those of us who study the process and know the plan can see it happening right under our nose. It is not far away. We have already been fractured into religious groups, racial groups, cultural groups, and now we've been fractured into you know, everyone in this country used to be proud to say that they were a patriot. Very proud. And anyone who would dare say they were not a patriot would be ostracized. Now they have turned the tables. If you're proud to be an American, if you understand the importance of the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, you are now some kind of terrible demon terrorist, racist, anti-government. What else? Fill in the blanks. You've got a lot of words to choose from. And it isn't even true. None of it. And all of these people who were so proud about going off to fight World War II and Korea for freedom and for the Constitution are now sitting back on their big fat butts with their retirement check in their pocket. And they don't give a damn. Not one ounce of anything. They don't care. You see, because if they stand up and really fight for their country, and really fight for freedom, and really fight for the Constitution in their own country, which is the only place that we should legitimately ever be fighting for those things, they might lose their little old retirement check. Yeah, I'm talking to you, you loudmouth, beer-swilling VFW puke. I'm talking directly to you. You're just as much to blame as the Marxist occupying the White House. In fact, ladies and gentlemen, if you really want to know who's to blame for all of this, go look in the mirror in your bathroom. The answer will be staring you in the face, literally. For those of you who do care, join militias, or form militias. Arm yourselves. Get ready. Prepare. Because you're either going to go into the New World Order as a docile little slave and put the chains around your own ankles, or you're going to stand and protect and defend the Constitution and freedom for all peoples with those of us who are not going to be anybody's slave anytime, under any circumstances, for any reason whatsoever. And for those of you who understand that, call Swiss America Trading and get your hands on some real money, because you're going to need it. And remember, when the buffalo chip hits the fan, folks, and it's going to, if you're not prepared, even if you want to join and stand with us, we can't take you, because you will be a burden. If you don't have your own food, your own weapon, your own ammunition, your own clothes, we can't give you ours, because then we can't fight. We can't stand. We can't perform our duty. So you have to take care of business now, right now, this minute. And one of the things you have to do is call Swiss America Trading at 1-800-289-2646. That's 1-800-289-2646. Do it now. You'll be glad that you did. And if you think that I'm full of it, ladies and gentlemen, get your butts up off your couches. Unentangle your hand from that Budweiser can. Straighten out your fingers so that they resemble the hands of a human and not a branch-grabbing ape. Get your nose in some books in a Federal Depository library. If you want a head start, you can purchase the treason documents from us for $85. If you don't like to read, you can buy the past tapes of this broadcast where I have enumerated the New World Order and treaties, documents, the Congressional Record, the Federal Register, in the law, in the writings of the fraternal organizations, of some of the people that you believe are great people but are really not. William Clinton and his wife Hillary are screaming Marxist socialists, and so is his whole cabinet. Jimmy Carter and Zbigniew Brzezinski are screaming Marxist socialists, and so was Carter's whole cabinet. If you really want to know what's going to happen in the future, ladies and gentlemen, get the books written by Zbigniew Brzezinski, also a very high-ranking member of the Council on Foreign Relations and the Trilateral Commission, and read what he has to say. If you don't believe what I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, get everything that you can that Mikhail Gorbachev has ever written, including his book Perestroika, and what he has been writing now, and read what he writes. You see, unlike other radio hosts, I don't just get on here and talk. I give you the documentation. I've been doing it for 4 years. If you're a new listener, you don't know that. Get a tape list. Order the tapes where I talked about the New World Order, organizations like the ADL, the World Federalists, the Treason series of tapes, and much, much more. If you think the militias are a bunch of criminals, then get your nose in the history books. Read the Federalist Papers. Read what our founding fathers really said about the militia and the second article and amendment to the Constitution, and how that would be our last defense against a despotic, oppressive, enslaving government. And then read the law about the militia. And you'll find out that you're being lied to on a grand scale. Those of you who saw Crossfire last night saw a dose of it. The guy that was supposed to be for the left and the guy that was supposed to be for the right, they're both on the same side, in case you didn't get the message. And there were more lies told in that 1.5-hour program than Goebbels told during the whole World War II. And who was this guy from the militia of Washington State? So every time they asked him a question about the militia, he started talking about the Federal Reserve and the IRS, you stupid jerk! If you don't know what you're talking about, keep your mouth shut. Send somebody who does. You looked like a fool. And I got to tell you, you were. Future can be your friend if you take hold and be its master, and if you put your feet solidly on the ground, it'll change your life. All the music you ever hear on this broadcast, ladies and gentlemen, has meaning. There's a message in it. So you'd better listen to it closely. The contents of A World 2010, A New Order of Nations, published by the Strategic Studies Institute, U.S. Army War College. Here's the table of contents. Forward, Chapter 1, Background and Process. Chapter 2, World International Order. Chapter 3, World Population. You won't believe what that says. Chapter 4, World Interdependence and Socio-Political Change. Chapter 5, World Energy, Science, Technology, and Space Exploration. Chapter 6, World Military Status. Chapter 7, National Challenges. Chapter 8, The Impact of the New Order. Chapter 9, U.S. Military Forces, and then End Notes. Selected Bibliography, Appendix, Estimative Semantics, Tables, the probable occurrence of trends and events in a world 2010, an arrangement of nations in 2010 by industrialization and modernization, some comparative characteristics of the new order of nations in 2010, traditional classification of countries and population estimates in millions, traditional classifications of countries and population estimates in millions, and that's a, I don't know why there's two different sections on that, but there is. Estimate of nations possessing nuclear power plants in 2010. Hypothetical estimates of nations possessing nuclear weapons in the year 2010. And theoretically, it's going to be zero except for the world government. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, I've been beating my head against the wall for 4 years, and we're running out of time. I don't know how else to do this. I started off being very polite, very nice, pleading, and, you know, thousands of people used to come and hear me speak, and they all go away and say, gee, what a nice guy that Bill Cooper is. I really liked him, and nothing ever changed. Nothing was done. Nobody got up off their butts. I've tried everything I know how. I've tried reaching out and smacking you upside the head with a verbal 2x4 through a radio speaker. I've tried pleading. I've tried documenting. I've tried everything in the world that I possibly can try. I don't know what else to do. If anybody out there's got any ideas, please let me know, because I'm just about out of them. I've tried making you love me. I've tried making you hate me. I've tried making you think more about the country and your fellow man than me or anybody else. I've tried to appeal to your humaneness, your idealistics, your love of freedom, you name it. I've tried every single thing in the book that I can try. I really don't know what else to try, ladies and gentlemen. And if none of this stuff is working, if you really don't care, if you really don't think that it can happen to you, if you really think you're going to survive this without losing anything, I wish you'd let me know that too, so that I can quit this stuff and do something that will make me and my family a lot happier in the time that we have left to enjoy what freedom we've got. Because I've got to tell you, folks, I'm not going into the New World Order. Period. If I have to fight the battle myself, I will. I know I won't be by myself. But I know that there's not going to be a whole lot of other people with me. That I'm certain of. At this point. So, if that's all there's going to be, then I want to know so that I can quit this baloney every night and do something that's a lot more fun. Talk about some things that I'd rather talk about. Some spiritual things. Some things that are maybe fun. Maybe provide more for my family than what this does. It doesn't provide anything. We don't make anything from this broadcast, folks. But if this is really doing something, if somehow I can reach out to you and make you become active before it's too late, if you elect Dole, he's going to give away the farm. If you elect Buchanan, he's going to give away the farm too. If you re-elect Clinton, he's going to give away the farm. You see, it doesn't matter when it gets on that level, ladies and gentlemen. You see, nobody at all had any belief in any possibility that Buchanan was actually going to get nominated and elected to the president. So what was all that vilifying in the press about? See, the press knew he wasn't going to get nominated or elected. Everybody knew he wasn't going to. It was a deception to make you believe that you had a spokesman that was going to make a deal with Dole and at the same time split the Republican Party and make sure that Clinton gets reelected. And if that's not enough, Ross Perot's United We Stand Party will field a candidate. And either way, Clinton's going to skate into the White House for another 4 years. If you don't believe that, stick around and watch it happen. In the meantime, think about what I've said tonight. You know, we don't have much time. We've got to do something. Good night. God bless you all. And God save the Republic.
Well, it's hard.